Steve French sent me two letters, one with the stamp and one without a stamp, and I actually got both, so two for the price of one. And let's take a look. So there's one there, and it looks like I got a second one. Ha! Two for the price of one. This one here from Braxton. This one's pretty cool. He's got multiples here. And then let's take a look at this one. Oh, look at this. It's a painting. This is from Jamie Costa, and it's been painted from George W. Bush. You can take a look at the video right over here. Let's watch a little bit of that clip.
Yeah. I like to give a border to my paintings. And, you know, a nice strong border, something that, you know, nothing's gonna cross in. And you can mix all kinds of things.
So what we'll be doing is making a wood frame around here, and I think I'll make it out of cherry. We'll try not to cover up the painting too much. And I've already talked to my homeowner's insurance policy, and I think we're gonna insure this for about $10,000, because that's probably what it's worth since it was painted from George W. Bush. It could be worth more. We'll work on this new project, and it should be very exciting. So George W. sent me this painting. This is actually rustic cherry, but a lot of it is pretty clear, as you can see. And I'm just going to keep the frame flat and have it go around this painting and not necessarily a crown going up. I don't make a lot of picture frames, so I'll just keep it simple. And I'll cut a rabbit into the frame so that this can go under. I'm not going to use those cardboard borders that you see on paintings. I don't think I'm going to do that on this. So here I'm going to apply some random router bits. I'm going to use a V-bit, a cope bit, and a 1/8 inch straight bit. So I'm just putting these randomly in place and we'll see how it turns out. This is what I used to make my rabbits, and you can see the bit's huge. So it allows me to do a really deep and really wide as well. The rabbits, and the ball bearing actually can change as well. So I can actually loosen this little Allen screw and then put in this wider ball bearing. So I made a straight edge fence for my router. It's basically just a piece of maple with some 45 degree angle cuts on there to center it, and this will give me a template for all four corners. And then I will apply a thin strip of maple to the miter joint to help keep it together and strengthen it. So now I'm just applying some red stain and spraying on a clear finish. So here we are, the project is complete. It will make an excellent backdrop with the Rooster Art project, and now we have the painting. Thank you for watching, and remember, when lifting heavy boxes, lift with your legs, not with your back.